releases 2205 and 2206 of SAP Business Application Studio have recently been made available. And with these releases come new features that make development of enterprise applications and extensions simpler and faster. These features are all described in detail in Yuval Anavi's blog post. There's guided development that provides guidance for specific development scenarios based upon best practices from SAP experts. In addition, there's support for personal data management, integration with SAP Launchpad service, features for composition and association with remote entities when extending SAP data, and developers can use the Service Center to discover and explore external data services. You can find all these details in Yuval's post, which also has information on the public roadmap and a link where you can subscribe to an SAP Business Application Studio monthly newsletter.
Hi everyone. UI5 was SAP Community Spotlight for the month of June, and for that, we started an SAP Community Code Challenge. It was about testing UI5 apps with VDI5, which is UI5's newest end-to-end testing framework. The task was to build an application that passes predefined tests. We had a lot of great submissions and feedback, and attendees got familiar with VDI5, which is great. The challenge was split up into 4 weekly challenges as we added a new test file every week. And week 4 is still running until July 6th, so it's not too late to catch up. For week 4, we are taking the training wheels off as it's now time to write your own VDI5 tests. Check out my blog post to learn more about it.
Hi everyone. With the latest AI business service, Personalized Recommendations, SAP now has a really cool portfolio for reusable and easy to implement machine learning services. There are a lot of new tutorials on the topic in our tutorial navigator, and this week we also released the first Tech Byte covering the business entity recognition service. In this Tech Byte, I show you how to use the Python SDK of the service to access its pre-trained models. You find the corresponding tutorials in the show notes. Make sure to also check out all the other great tutorials covering the different AI business services.
The SAP BTP SDK for iOS just shipped version 8.0 with amazing new features. So let's talk highlights. It is now possible to have SAP mobile services sign onboarding QR codes digitally to let the SDK verify the digital signature before proceeding with the onboarding process, making user onboarding even more secure. Always wanted to have feature restriction policies for your iOS apps? Wait no more. You can now set feature restrictions within SAP Mobile Services, and the SDK can read those to apply them to your iOS app. There are quite some new UI components as well. The SDK is introducing a list card which gives a preview of a set of items in a vertical list format. With the brand new object header, you have the option to provide a quick view of the most important or most frequently used information about one instance of an object. And finally, the object cell got a couple of enhancements providing more flexibility, like updates to layouts, spacing, avatar, and thumbnail sizing, and the support of informational elements. The SAP BTP SDK for iOS Assistant is adapting these new changes and applies the brand new Fiori Horizon theme to all generated apps. Get the new version today and check out all these great changes yourself.
An exciting opportunity to influence SAP has begun with the second cycle of 2022 SAP Customer Engagement. Jürgen Müller recently sent out a tweet where he has 2 different links. One is to a blog post that outlines all the different projects that are available to sign up for as part of the SAP Customer Engagement Initiative. This enables you, an SAP customer or partner, to get early insights into SAP's product developments and directly work with the developers to define and shape the future product directions. We are offering several interesting opportunities for customers to influence SAP's solution. Many of them are outlined in the first link in Jürgen's tweet, which is a blog post. The second link is very important though, as it is the registration page that allows you to sign up. Please register by July 8th, 2022 for any of the topic areas that you want to help influence.